First and foremost, I would like to thank Department of Physics, Namchi Government College and Sikkim University to provide this platform to make this topic perpendicular theorem of moment of inertia and provided by teacher Dr. C.P. Khatiwara, sir, for the partial fulfillment of BSc third semester, June to December 2020. This video carry 25 marks or sessional B examination. My name is Mikchiring Lepcha. Roll number is 19NS0137. And my topic is perpendicular theorem of moment of inertia. Today we will study about theorem of perpendicular axis. Now, what does this theorem says? For a plane lamina body. For a plane lamina body. This theorem says that the moment of inertia of a plane lamina about an axis perpendicular to its plane is equal to the sum of the moments of inertia of the lamina about any two mutually perpendicular axis in its own plane and intersecting each other at the point where the perpendicular axis is passing through it. Okay. Now, what it means, theorem of perpendicular axis. For a plane lamina body, this theorem says that the moment of inertia of a plane lamina about an axis perpendicular to its plane is equal to the sum of the moment of inertia of the lamina about any two mutually perpendicular axes in its own plane and intersecting each other at the point where the perpendicular axis is passing through it. Okay. That is where all the three axes intersecting each other. So this is the theorem perpendicular axis for the plane lamina body. Now we have to prove this theorem. Okay, let us draw plane lamina. Z, X, and Y. This is 0. Here is a point P, mass of M1. That point is M, and this point is N. This line is X1, and this line is Y1, and this is the radius R1. Okay, now let us consider a plane lamina. We have a consider a plane lamina. Okay, let OX and OY be two mutually perpendicular axis lying in the plane of the lamina and intersecting each other at point O. Okay. Excuse me. We have a consider OX and OY be the two mutually perpendicular to this Z. Okay. Axis lying in the plane of a lamina intersecting each other at the point of O. Now further, let OZ be the axis perpendicular to their plane and passing through same point O. That is all these three axes OX, OY and OZ are the intersecting each other at a common point at O. Okay, now if Ix is equals to moment of inertia of the lamina about x-axis Iy equals to moment of inertia of the lamina about y axis and Iz equals to moment of the lamina about moment of inertia of the lamina about z axis. Then according to this theorem says that moment of inertia of plane lamina about an axis perpendicular to its plane that is z axis is equal to the sum of moment of inertia of a lamina about any two mutually perpendicular axes in each own plane says x and y axis intersecting the point where the perpendicular axis is passing through it. Now according to this theorem we have Ix, Iy, Iz be the three moment of inertia about x axis, y axis and z axis respectively. Then Iz equals to Ix plus Iy. We have to prove this one. This is the theorem of perpendicular axis. Okay. Now we will prove this theorem. So prove this theorem. Proof. Let us imagine. We have to imagine. Let us imagine that lamina is divided into large number of elementary particles of masses m1 m particle of masses m1 m2 m3 m4 dot 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 so on. Okay, let us consider one particles of mass m1 at point P at the distance x1 and y1 from y axis and x axis respectively. respectively. Also, also let its distance from O B R 1. Okay. The distance from O B R 1. Okay. Then, obviously, R 1 squared equals to X 1 squared plus Y 1 squared. This is the point here. At the point of masses M1 at the distance of x1 from y-axis and y1 from x-axis. Now its distance from point O, let it be R1. Okay, R1. Now clearly this R1 has a relation with this X. And Y1. According to Pythagoras' theorem, this triangle OMP, this angle M is a right angle. Therefore, R1 square equals to Y1 square plus X1 square. Okay. Now moment of inertia of whole lamina about x axis be the I x equals to m1 y1 squared plus m2 y2 squared plus dot, which is equals to summation of my square. What it be the value? Let us say we have this particle of mass m1 at the distance of y1 from x axis. So its moment end of inertia about x axis will be the equal to the mass m1 into square of the distance that is y1 square. Therefore, considering this value, the whole lamina, the moment of inertia is whole lamina about x axis will be the same way. That is, m1 y1 square is the first particle, m2 y2 is the second particle, m3 y3 square is the third particle, where m1 m2 m3 are the masses of the particle particle and y1 y2 y3 are the distance of the particle from x axis. Now in the same way, the moment of inertia of whole lamina about y axis Iy equals to m1 x1 square plus m2 x2 square, which is equals to summation of mx square. So let us consider the same point, that is point of mass m1 at the same point P at the distance x1 from the y axis. Therefore its moment of inertia y axis will be the m1 y1 square. Considering this into the whole lamina R, we can find out the moment of inertia of the whole lamina about y axis. What will be the its value is equal to m1 x1 square is the first particle and m2 x2 is the second particle. m3 x3 square is the third particle and so on. Okay, where x1 x2 are distance of the particle of masses of the particle masses m1 m2 respectively from y axis now let r1 r2 are the distance of particles of masses m1 m2 respectively from O, that is x-axis, z-axis. Again, then moment of the lamina about z-axis Iz equals to m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus the curl, which is equals to summation of mr square, or Iz equals to m1 r1 square plus m2 r2 square plus m1 x1 square plus y1 square plus m2 x2 square plus y2 square plus m1 x1 square plus m2 x2 square plus m2 y m1 y1 square plus m2 y2 square, which is m1 x1 square plus m2 x2 square is which is equals to summation of m x square plus same as m1 y1 square plus m2 y2 square is equals to summation of m y square. Summation of m x square is I x plus summation of m y square is I y. That is I x plus I y equals to I z or I z equals to I x plus I y. Hence, proof.